Penguin Random House Audio presents Help Is On The Way, Stay Up and Live Your Truth by Kountry Wayne with Mim Eichler Rivas. Foreword by Cedric the Entertainer. This is the author, Kountry Wayne. This book is dedicated to the memory of my mother, Melissa Coney. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Isaiah 41:10. Author's note. Growing up in the country as I did, stories well told and lessons well taught come from actual experience. That's what you'll find in this book, and recollections that are faithfully described, although certain names of people have been changed, along with identifying details associated with those individuals. Though I consider myself to be an excellent listener, I have a pretty good recall, too. It's important to note that words of dialogue I've included in actual conversations are not intended to be word-for-word reenactments. The exchanges I have written, however, are nonetheless recalled in the spirit of how they were spoken at the time. Foreword by Cedric the Entertainer. The first time I met Kountry Wayne, not too many years ago, was at the Atlanta Comedy Theater where I had arrived to headline two sold-out shows that night. Wayne, in his late 20s and the father of 9 kids, give or take, had just started to gain momentum as a stand-up, building on the success of his viral comedy videos that drew from his life growing up in a small country town in southeast Georgia. Now, I didn't know many of those details when he first approached me at the club after the second show was over. I come to Atlanta, always a welcoming city for me, as one of the first stops on a much longer tour. The small room at ACT get packed to the gills, which makes it a great spot for testing out new material. You could gauge the response to a joke by how cold or hot it becomes in there, real fast. Fortunately, the new stuff cranked the heat up right away, and I had everybody in the club falling out laughing. So I was feeling pretty good as I stepped off the stage and spotted this young, eager-looking dude heading in my direction. The first thing I noticed was that he was wearing the Dallas Cowboys beanie hat, which takes some nerve in Atlanta, Georgia, where locals take pride in their Falcons. The best way to describe my first impression of Wayne Coley is that he seemed to shine with a bright light and was completely confident, self-assured, yet respectful, and not afraid just to be a fan. "Cedric," he began and reached out to shake my hand. "That was amazing. You're one of my top favorite comedians ever." I thanked him as he went on to say, "Getting to see you in person is a highlight of my life." He quickly added that he had been doing stand-up for a couple of years and was starting to spend more time out in L.A., where he had been booking some acting gigs, too. At that point, he introduced himself. "Kountry Wayne," I said. "Cool." "Intrigued," I asked. "What's your style of comedy?" Not skipping the beat, he replied, "Classic entertainment mixed with stand-up." He said that was the blueprint he learned from comedy OGs like me. I liked the fact that he made no effort to talk any other way than how he did, with a thick country drawl. It's not like the white southern kind of drawl that sounds like too much sugar in your sweet tea. Black country dialect is almost slangy, with dropped consonants at the end of words, and fresh expressions you may never have heard that can be cutting without you even knowing it. I said something along the lines of, "Keep on doing what you're doing, and I have a feeling we'll be seeing a lot of you in the comedy world." "Yeah, for sure," he said, or words to that effect, thanked me, and took off. After meeting Kountry Wayne the first time, I started to follow him on social media and was impressed. Over the next couple of years, his star continued to rise and his orbit expanded, from dating superstars to doing film and TV appearances to becoming an entrepreneur, producer, and philanthropist. By 2019, Kountry Wayne was defying all odds and, in my view, had emerged as the leader of the new school of comedians who understood how to build an audience in the 21st century, both in the viral universe and in brick-and-mortar comedy venues of all sizes. For that reason, I wanted to lean towards his experience and open whatever doors I could for him. In the process, I reached out to him to talk about potentially developing some content together, and what followed has been and continues to be immensely rewarding for both of us. As I explained to Wayne, at the time when I was just getting a foothold in comedy, there weren't many mentors who were able to take young comedians of our generation under their wings. Nobody had been there to make a way for Richard Pryor, and the same was true for Eddie Murphy. Fortunately for Eddie, he had been given a massive lunch from SNL. In between stand-up and an epic stream of blockbuster hit movies, he soon blazed a trail of his own. When Chris Rock got his own boost from SNL, that's when things changed somewhat, and Eddie Murphy stepped in to help Chris gain a credibility as a stand-up in a much faster amount of time than it would have taken on his own. When I was getting started, I had the great fortune to connect with Steve Harvey, and after we worked together on Kings of Comedy, the two of us would take turns pulling the other in on whatever latest projects we were on. Wayne ate up this history as if it were biblical. He could sit and ask questions for hours about how to achieve the same success or greater as early influences. He has that visionary, hustler mentality and is always looking for how to top others as well as himself. Wayne is serious about making all the right moves, and he is someone who doesn't let much grass grow under his feet. He might ask, Sid, what were the lessons you had to learn to really make it? The two main lessons I shared with him were the ones he had learned already and are including up ahead and helpers on the way. But they may have been lessons he needed to be reminded of. First, as I tell everyone trying to make it in the entertainment or in any competitive field, you can't skip the steps. The Kountry Wayne version of this is, mind your business. It's true. You not only have to build each step of your ladder before you can ascend it, but if you rush and don't take pride of your creation, no amount of success is going to make you feel like you've made it. Plus, if you skip one of those rungs, you won't have any way to land if you do have to take a step down. Something Wayne learned on his own that I believe in strongly is that you have to build your career with love or something you nourish. You birth it, you raise it, you treat it like a baby or a beloved pet that you care for unconditionally, and that will care for you back. Unlike many of the internet comics who managed to build a massive audience without stepping onto a stage, Wayne has done both cultivating his family of fans who have been with him on his rides in his social media comedy sketch series and in the clubs and theaters where he is headlining and selling out more and more. Wayne has put in the work, and that integrity is why so many OG comics respect him and the route he has taken to get where he is. The second lesson I shared with Wayne was one I had to learn the hard way, and it was something he knew well. Live your truth. Early in my career, I didn't have the wisdom to know if you try to change yourself to conform to what you think the powers that be want from you, it could do you in. The lesson came after I had more and less booked a TV show after having the door opened for me by Steve Harvey. The deal was all but sealed, so I was flown to New York to do a showcase for the network just to make everybody laugh and feel good about casting me, I guess. Steve was there to be a part of what was going to be the next exciting chapter in both of our comedy lives. Every white executive at the network had gathered in a room with a catered gourmet meal, and I started to think twice about my risque material and my St. Louis, Missouri, Walker's delivery, and I decided to change my dialect and make it more everyman Midwestern or something, and even my delivery point. On the fly, I just decided to change my whole set. Nobody laughed. Nobody cracked a smile. The more I tried, the icier it got in the room. This wasn't bumming in front of just any crowd. These were the network executives who had hired me already based on Steve Harvey's belief in me. Inside, I was dying because a lot of the executives didn't know who I was, and my bumming so bad was going to make them question Steve's judgment too. Before I could wrap up my set, out of the corner of my eye, I watched Steve come up on the stage, grab the mic from me, and cuss all of those execs' asses out. It was the opposite of what I was trying to do. He was so authentically himself. It was hilarious to him cuss at them for not laughing at me. Look at y'all. Y'all got somewhere to go? There was a beat before he went further asking, what happened? Y'all ran out of crudités and ranch? Are you hungry or something? Steve got every single one of them to laugh at themselves to the point of tears running down their faces because he was that funny. Later, Steve emphasized the lesson, telling me, you should never change your set for somebody else. Be who you are authentically. That's what makes you different. That's your edge. He admitted that it might not work in every setting, but that's the risk you take, and if you bomb being yourself, that's not on you. And so be it. That has always been one of the most important lessons in my life, and as you're going to hear shortly, it has always been a pivotal lesson for Kountry Wayne, the one and only. The father of 19 kids, Wayne has come a long way since we first met. In the summer of 2022, I caught his act for the first time when his Straight Outta Mud tour brought him to L.A. as part of the Netflix Is a Joke Festival. I expected him to bring down the house, and I was not disappointed in the least. He exceeded expectations, and I was so proud to see him up there, working clean, by the way, and as commanding and professional as much older show business veterans. His show is part seduction and part revival. And that's kind of how I feel about Wayne's book. You are in for a rag-to-riches story full of inspiration and practical guidance. He really believes in passing on the goods that he has learned to you. Whatever our conversations, business...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.